Rush the enemy! Defend Gilneas!
Defend the gates!
The gates are open.
One for all, and all for me.
A symphony of terror begins. Take heart, young one. The Earth Mother is near.
Let the pain speak to me.
Thank you.
want.
Thank you. rotten to my core.
Morgul versus Jaina.
You asked for it. Are you my master?
spirit, twist the tree, foul the lake, and curse this land!
I serve the Fire Lord.
You know, take care.
Morgul versus Arthas.
For Lordaeron.
Are you my master? This way, this way, this way. This way.
I will slay.
This way. This way. This way.
Do you hear its call?
This way. This way.
Listen closely.
Not on my watch.
This way. This way.
How long can this go on? How long can this go on?
No more take candles.
Reporting for duty.
Oh!
Reporting for duty.
C'thun! C'thun! C'thun!
Do you hear its call? Listen closely.
Reporting for duty. Reporting for duty. Reporting for duty. No! Reporting for duty. Reporting for duty.
Do you have the artifact?
Reporting for duty. Reporting for duty.
My jaws that bite, my claws that catch.
Done. no more take candles.
The
reporting
curse
for duty.
Take you.
Reporting for duty. 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 For the glory of Stormwind. Reporting for duty.
Not on my watch.
Reporting for duty.
But of course.
Sleeper has awoken.
has broken.
How long can this go on? How long can this go on?
Reporting for duty.
I'm almost out of cards.
Accidents. They happen, you know?
Eureka! I've done it!
Reporting for duty.
I'm almost out of cards.
Let's show our guests a good time.
Morgul versus Uther.
I will fight with honor.
Undo rolls.
Job's done.
Doesn't love Yoda. He's a little green mystical guru who rides around in a hover chair and beats robots with sticks. Oh yeah, and he's a seasoned general, war hero, and possibly the strongest force user in the galaxy. But like a lot of stuff related to Star Wars, once you dig deeper into the movies and broader canon, you start to realize stuff you might not have noticed at first. Like that this miniature Jedi Master can be a huge jerk. Here's a look back at the worst things Yoda has ever done. Doing Ahsoka wrong. In The Phantom Menace, one of Yoda's concerns about accepting Anakin Skywalker into the Jedi Order is that he's not only too old, but also too attached to his mother. Nevertheless, Obi-Wan is allowed to train Anakin. The wider Star Wars canon saw Yoda still concerned about Anakin's tendency to become emotionally attached, and in the Clone Wars animated film, Yoda decided to give Anakin a Padawan of his own in Ahsoka Tano, hoping that her eventual ascendancy to Jedi knighthood would rob Anakin of this tendency. But why would he consider that a good idea? A Padawan like Ahsoka would get much better training from someone who wasn't, you know, also a Padawan. The final arc of the Clone Wars 5th season again saw Yoda and Ahsoka at cross purposes. When the Jedi Temple was bombed, Anakin and Ahsoka were called to investigate. Although Ahsoka had nothing to do with the bomb, the true culprit framed her for it. After escaping and being recaptured, Ahsoka was expelled from the Jedi Order by the Council. Except, as Yoda admitted at one point in the storyline, his ability to commune with the Force had become clouded due to the events of the war. If that's the case, why was he put in charge of such a monumental decision? Even Padme quickly deduced that Ahsoka couldn't have committed the crime she was being framed for, and she's as far from Jedi as you can get. If Yoda knew he couldn't see the truth, he should have stepped aside rather than risk unjustly ruining Ahsoka's life. Keeping Sith Secrets. In the 6th season Clone Wars episode The Lost One, Yoda, Mace Windu, and Obi-Wan discover the truth of what happened to Sifo Dyas, the Jedi Master revealed to have ordered the Clone Army's creation in Attack of the Clones. The episode shows that decades ago, Sifo Dyas's ship was shot down by a crime syndicate paid by Count Dooku. Dooku then impersonated Sifo Dyas and ordered the creation of the clones. Yoda decides that the only course of action the Jedi have is to keep the truth to themselves.
Cover up this discovery. We must.
Except that definitely isn't all they could have done. Exposing this betrayal could have resulted in the withdrawal of the Clone Army, the discovery of the inhibitor chip that enabled Order 66, and a better way out of the Clone Wars. Uncovering your enemy's plans, then recovering them, is a pretty stupid thing to do. A push to the dark side. In Revenge of the Sith, as part of the final salvo of his plan, Chancellor Palpatine appointed Anakin as a special representative on the Jedi High Council. The Council agreed, with one condition.
You're on this council, but we do not grant you the rank of Master.
It was a first in the history of the Council, and Anakin didn't take it well. Even with the rising dark side clouding his vision, Yoda could have surely seen that Anakin was at a breaking point. Even if Yoda didn't know the details of Anakin's increasingly unbalanced private life, it was obvious that the young Jedi was in crisis, and denying him the rank of Master might have been the final straw that pushed him to turn completely to the dark side. Quitting time. One of the biggest controversies sparked amongst Star Wars fans by the prequel trilogy was its depiction of Yoda as a highly accomplished fighter, not just a wise old Jedi Master. But even fans who preferred the more sedate version of the little guy had to admit that Yoda's battle with Emperor Palpatine made for an emotionally charged sequence. On the other hand, the end of it all is unbelievably lame. Having realized that they're evenly matched and he really can't win, Yoda makes an escape, but then rather than making any